Good morning, world. Good morning, universe. 7:38 a.m. July 15, 2014. I want to share some things with you people so that you truly understand me and not misunderstand me, as so many self-righteous Christians have. I'm going to share some scriptures also to show you. When I told you this book is about slavery, it is. I'm going to share some scriptures with you tribes to understand. When I said that this is by lesser gods and co-creators, that book really is about that. It's about slavery. And I don't want to be misunderstood any longer, because I have the rights and the authority to say that there should be no more religions. And a lot of you will misinterpret that, just like y'all have misinterpreted the parables that Christ Jesus has spoken. He was not taught by Pharisees and Sadducees or scribes. He was taught by the Eternal, the Mother of all life. And I can show you a parable in here, and it's Matthew 9:4-6, when he told the man, the paraplegic, what is it better to say? Your sins have been forgiven you, or pick up your cot and walk? Let's read that, because this is the reason I have been hated in the Christian community from childhood, because of my understanding of biblical scriptures and in I guess they would call it the Gospels, which is God's spell. Okay, let's go there, people, so that I can show you. Matthew 9:4-6, Mark 2:9, Luke 5:23, they're all the same scripture. To see. I'll find my glasses. We're going to read that whole little part, because y'all think y'all are sinners, huh? Where's my glasses? Alright. You think you're a sinner, right? Let's go to Matthew 9:4-6. And it says, but Jesus, knowing their thoughts, said, why do you think evil in your hearts? For which is easier, to say, your sins are forgiven you, or to say, arise and walk? But that you may know that the Son of Man has power on earth to forgive sins. Then he said to the paraplegic, arise, take up your bed and go to your home. Let's go to Luke 5:23, because it says the same thing. I'm going to share with you what sin is. Sin is not like you think it is. Sin is actually crimes of lawless deeds, because everything in the universe has laws. And most things have boundaries. And that's what sin is. To commit deeds, crimes, lawlessness, breaking laws, breaking boundaries. And we're going to go through some scriptures too, tribes, to show you why the earth and everything is in such an uproar. Okay, we're going to go to Luke 5:23. And it says, well, we're going to go to 22 first. But when Jesus perceived their thoughts, he answered and said to them, why are you reasoning in your hearts? Which is easier to say, your sins are forgiven you, or to say, rise up and walk? Which is easier to say? Your sins are forgiven you, or rise up and walk? You people of the letter, you people of the book, you people of buildings of churches. So y'all are going to get a first-hand glimpse of why I'm hated, why they practice such evil ritual occults upon me to deter me from my purpose. I'm fully aware that we're all under a duality here. This is a duality realm, people, of good and evil. And you got to learn to strike the balance. There is no sin that is unforgivable, but breaking the law of God, which is written in your heart and shouldn't be written on papers and papyruses. And that's why they killed my son. That's why the Son of Man was hushed up in 3.5 years, taken away from them. Because they could not bear that he was full of the Spirit from above, from high above. Now, we talked about boundaries, and it is lawless to steal land, you know. It's lawless to do that. Let's go to Proverbs 22:28. I'm so tired of being misunderstood by deceived Christians with a false gospel who want to persecute me. Y'all have destroyed your grace. Because when I was small and used to attend the kingdom halls and make comments, I was able to explain in simplicity what these things meant and began to be hated from very young. Let's go to 22. And I had some of you Christians a few years ago telling me I need to be saved. I am your Savior. My son was your Savior. And y'all think that I had no godliness in me? Not only did you pity me, you persecuted me. And then tried to destroy my mind, the seed of my soul. And then had me physically raped. Out of hatred. Okay, tribes, let's go here, Native Indians. Because I don't even think I need to be sharing with you, you fake Christians. You fundamentalists, 22:28. Do not remove the ancient landmarker which your fathers have set. Let's go to 23:10. Do not remove the ancient landmark nor enter the fields of the fatherless. Deuteronomy 19. Sometimes it says boundaries in certain written text here. 19:14. You shall not remove your neighbor's landmark, which the men of old have set in your inheritance, which you will inherit in the land that the Lord your God is giving you to possess. Why did you people from Europe come over here and do that? Let's go to Job 24:2. You remove boundaries. That's why those people in Mexico coming over the borders, they have every right to be here on these lands. Let's go to Job. And then I'm going to read some scriptures that confirm tribes, how these war gods of this book have used it to destroy y'all. It's written here in history. This is like history. Let's go to Job 24:2, where it says what they'll do. Job is before Psalms. Yeah. 24:2. Some remove landmarks that seize rocks violently and feed on them. Mm-hmm. Some remove landmarks. Now they have in other texts, it says boundaries that they remove. Let's go to Nahum chapter 3 verse 10, and it's going to show you about this slavery here I talk about. You'll understand that this book is about slavery and all the gods in it is about slavery. And that's why I say there don't need to be any more religions or no more church buildings that you false Christians gather in and thinking y'all are doing a service to Jesus Christ, whom y'all strung up on Calvary and created monarchs all across this planet and set up your little false churches. I don't care if y'all don't like me anymore. I don't care what y'all think of me anymore. You're bent and you can't get straight. And I'm sorry if y'all have misinterpreted me. And I also want to discuss some things. People's lifestyles, homosexuals, gays, transgenders. I don't judge people like that. That is their personal choice. It's not my choice. It's not something I would like to be. But the mind weapons and mind control is so high, y'all, under so much MK Ultra, that some of you ain't really like that. They mind control you to be that way. Y'all better think about it, to invert you, to confuse you. Now, where was I supposed to be going? Nahum. And this is going to turn out to be kind of long. Come on, Nahum. That's my brother's name. And before it's over with, I'm going to read a poem that I wrote in 2010 on my son's father's birthday to show you how my thoughts are. Nahum. Sometimes I hate flipping through this book. I just like the spirit to just flow through me. All right, this is it. This is Mike as Jonah. Nahum would be before Jonah. Daniel. And them mind controlling me was all to keep me silent and not be able to teach some of you. Nahum 3. Let's see. 10. Yeah. is going to say about the slavery. Yet she was carried away, she went into captivity, her young children also were dashed to pieces. At the head of every street they cast lots for her honorable men, and all her great men were bound in chains. Straight there tells you about slavery. And that's at Nahum 3:10. Now let's go to Hosea 13:10. Do you think of God, the creator of all there is, would promote this? Mm-mm. Not the mother. Not the real Jesus. Let's go to Hosea. And they are upset, these false Christians, because they don't want me to dispel their lies. They want to keep it going, want to keep their theft up, but it ain't going to happen. Because I tell you, this whole place will burn to the ground. If I say to burn it, it will burn. Y'all done mess with the angry child. And I don't care if y'all think I'm arrogant. I have important work to do here to set matters straight. And y'all have interfered with it with some very perverse, filthy crap upon my life. So that y'all can jar and mock. And think you have reasons to judge me. Okay, here it is. Now, the true one would not create this at all. Hosea 13:16. Let's go. Tribes, pay attention, native tribes, indigenous. Because this was what befell y'all behind a slavery. Samaria is held guilty for she has rebelled against her God. They shall fall by the sword. Their infants shall be dashed in pieces, and their women with child ripped open. You see that, huh? Let's go to Amos chapter 1. It's going to go all through here. 1:13. Thus says the Lord, for their transgression, for the three transgressions of the people of Ammon, and four, I will not turn away its punishment, because they ripped open the women with child in Gilead, that they might enlarge their territory. Territory that y'all stole, and you use the word Gilead. There's been some geographical rearrangements, people. You understand the wording of certain states and areas. But this is exactly what happened to you indigenous tribes. So they can enlarge their territory. You war gods. Let's go here to 2 Kings. Because this is another one that speaks very much about the dashing of women to pieces. And cutting open pregnant women. And Hazael said, this is 2 Kings chapter 8, verse 12. And Hazael said, why is my Lord weeping? He answered, because I know the evil that you will do to the children of Israel. Their strongholds you will set on fire, and their young men you will kill with the sword, and you will dash their children and rip open their women with child. That's what y'all did. And you tried to hide that the native tribes and indigenous people are the people in the Bible that y'all have been perpetrating punishment upon. Okay, let's go here to Hosea 10:13-14, because that talks about it too. 10:13-14. You have plowed wickedness. You have reaped iniquity. You have eaten the fruit of lies because you trust in your own way, in the multitude of your mighty men. Therefore, tumult shall arise among your people, and all your fortresses shall be plundered. As shall man plunder Bethel Arbel in the day of battle, a mother dashed in pieces upon her children. Little game y'all been playing, huh? Look here at Psalms. Even in Psalms it's recorded. 137. verse 9. Happy the one who takes and dashes your little ones against the rock. I'm also going to go to a scripture that even talks about Syria. And that would be at, let me see where I wrote it down. I think I wrote it. Matthew 4:24. And it talks about Syria and the glory of Syria. And that's why so much chaos in the Middle East behind what y'all have done. 4:24. Then his fame went throughout all Syria, and they brought to him all sick people who were afflicted with various diseases and torments, and those who were demon-possessed, epileptics and paraplegics, and he healed them. This is talking about Jesus Christ, the real one. He was well known in Syria. And you see the miracles that he performed there. And they said, and he healed them. Where did he learn to heal? From his loving mother. The healer. Not from you fallen deities who conspired and ganged up on him 2,000 years ago to silence his message and steal it and incorporated in a bunch of churches. And y'all have tried to destroy the spirit of Syria, the Middle East, Iraq, Romania, now United States. It looks like y'all just went around trying to terrorize all the tribes, even the ones in South America. Well, people, I'm going to read this poem to you that I wrote in 2010 of September 3rd, 2010. That's Dwayne R. Parker's birthday. I wrote this poem. And it's called Song of Heart. It says, you are like a song that all nations sing. Every tongue knows your words, for it is you, it is good news you bring. A perfect face, no flaws, are you bound by any laws? Deep and profound is your love for all living things. I too understand when the bird sings, even when the church bell rings. You chase me away for fear that love will turn bad. Please don't be sad. Please don't be mad. Make my heart glad, for you are like a song in my heart, a beautiful tune. How soon shall we not look upon the moon? It's such a cold place where their rituals and magic reside, creating pain for us. It's creating pain. A cycle so dark, so cold, so strange. Time for us to change the tune. They keep calling down the moon. You're a song I waited to sing for so long. I waited to right the wrong. They worship the sun. They worship the moon. They worship the stars. They engage in wars for no reason. It's our season to sing the song of heart. So, tribes, have a blessed morning this morning. And sometimes it bothers me that I'm so misunderstood by so many people, especially those that are self-righteous in their lawless crimes.